Hey, good afternoon, friends. How are you all? So we are back again with our topic. So let us discuss today. So what more information can we get from a balanced equation? What more information can we get from a balanced equation? This making the balanced equation more informative. So more informative means what? What could be the information? Its physical state, that means whether it is solid or liquid or gas. Means the reactants. Okay, the reactants, whether the reactants in the beginning, whether they are solid or liquid or gas. Okay, so this is one of the information. Next step. So whether any, after the reaction is completed, whether any precipitate is formed. Okay, this is one of the things. Or any gas is formed or still, whether any heat is liberated out. Okay, heat is liberated out. Means what? Heat liberated exo. Heat is liberated out means heat is liberated to the surroundings or the particular container, whether it is a beaker or a jar, whatever it is. So this is another information. That means whether the reaction is liberating heat out, which means exothermic reaction, or it is absorbing heat from the surrounding. It is absorbing heat from the surrounding, means endothermic. Endothermic. So for an exothermic reaction, we will indicate plus Q. Okay, plus Q after the reaction is, after we write the reaction. Then if it is endothermic, we write minus Q after the reaction. Or still if we, if any other factors like sunlight, etc., whether they are involved, we indicate even that also. Suppose, for example, if you take decomposition of silver bromide, AgBr. Okay, so it is yellowish in color in the beginning. Okay, so when you keep it in sunlight, you keep it in sunlight, what happens is it becomes into gray color. Silver bromide, which is in yellowish color in the beginning, when you keep it in sunlight, it decomposes into silver and bromine. Silver and bromine, and in turn, after that also, it turns into gray color. Gray color. Okay, so this is one of the examples. So, yes, sunlight is involved. So, on the arrow mark, you write sunlight. Next, for example, you take this chlorophyll, green plants. So, in the presence of carbon dioxide water, they synthesize glucose. Okay, or glucose if it is decomposing. Okay, in the presence of sunlight, etc., the factors. So, we write all of these. So, one by one, I will write here. Then we will go into the explanation so that you can understand very well. Right. So, the first thing I am writing is single state. Okay, single state. Physical state means, then next one, the next one, heat changes, which means exothermic or endothermic reaction. Exothermic or endothermic reaction. So next one. So the third factor can be liberation of any gas. That's the law of the beginning. Yes, about. Because we have seen a few equations, suppose zinc and hydrochloric acid. Like in the previous class, what we have discussed, no? So when we take zinc granules in a small conical flask and add some 10 ml of hydrochloric acid, we get a gas. The gas is liberated. So, gas evolved. So, this is any. Then the next one I want to write is precipitate obtained, if any. Otherwise, so why we are writing if any? If any means if it is evolved, we indicate. Otherwise, no. So, here also. Precipitate, if it is formed, we will indicate it by keeping a downward arrow. And keep it. So, and then finally, climatic changes or temperature changes. So, what is the involvement of factors like unlike, etc. No, no, we will sum it up like this. So, for each one, we will discuss with an example. So, these are the things what we have. We can the balance the equation to give us more information, right? So, even we can calculate the molar mass, formula unit, its molar volume, molecular problem, molecular weight, everything. Okay, that we will do for our continuing discussion, right? So, for the example, what I read is, we decompose one product, P2O3 plus aluminium, 2 plus 2, right, so here, what do we have? 2AB, so, 2AB. So, this is a solid, this is also a solid. So, this is also a solid, and this is also a solid. So, all are solid solid. Okay, then here, what can we get to? So, by 18. Here, one small line is given. So, here, here. This triangle symbol, small triangle symbol, okay, indicate B. The same triangle symbol we have discussed in kinematics also. Okay, in kinematics, okay, to write, we have used this, okay, what is that? Small triangle symbol. So, here in kinematics, that triangle symbol indicates a slight change. Suppose, V bar is equal to V bar, velocity is equal to delta, or this one we treat as delta x by delta V. Or similarly, acceleration J bar equal to delta V by delta V. The change of rate of change of velocity, rate of change of displacement, rate of change of whatever it is. Okay? So here this delta indicates what? Slight change. So this is not our discussion now. Okay. So we leave this one for a while. Okay. Okay. So here our main discussion is regarding this chemical reaction part. Okay. So here, what does this delta indicate mean? It indicates GP. Okay, don't worry. So here in this information means this reaction. What is the information we are having? If P2O3, it is a solid. Okay, then aluminium is a solid. Then, upon heating, it is giving rise to aluminium oxide or aluminium trioxide, and iron is liberated. Again, these are also solids only. So now, here, once again, if you see, 2 moles of aluminium is utilized. Okay, so when 2 moles of aluminium is utilized, we are getting 2 moles of iron. Okay, 2 moles of aluminium. In the LHS, we are getting 2 moles of iron also. So that means they are in equal ratios. Means whatever the weight of aluminium we use, that much weight of iron we will get. Okay, this is the information what we are getting. Okay, so total is balanced now. So we will go for the another example. Okay, expressing the heat changes. Okay, now this one is over. Second one, expressing the heat changes, let us see with a few examples. Okay, so expressing the heat changes. For example, we take very simplest equation, carbon plus oxygen gives rise to carbon dioxide. So this is a gas. So this is a gas, and also in this reaction, what is happening is, okay, heat is evolved. So that means here we get plus two. Heat is there. So okay. So we check whether it is balanced or CO2. Okay, balance. Okay. So as this is a gas, we indicate it as upward arrow. Now another small example. Okay. Nitrogen. Nitrogen plus oxygen is rise to NO2. Okay, nitrogen monoxide. Okay, so this is also a gas, but this is absorbing. This is a endothermic
reaction is an endothermic reaction.
Okay, students, are you getting? So, but let us take a little bit of 2 nitrogen, 2 nitrogen. So, here, just we need a 2 here. So, 2 nitrogen, 2 oxygen, please. Okay, this, as it is indicated in the minus 2 means, it is absorbing, means it is taking heat from the surrounding. So, first one, so we see iron oxide and aluminum, so we are getting by heating. Next here, carbon and oxygen, when they react, what is formed is, ionomer formed, here heat is liberated, carbon dioxide is formed, of course. But along with the liberation of heat. Next, nitrogen and oxygen are combined. You know what? This is nitrogen monoxide. Say that
nitrogen monoxide.
Monoxide. If it is NO2, means we speak it as nitrogen dioxide. Okay. So here, nitrogen monoxide is a poisonous gas. Okay, for your kind of information. So, here we are getting this one. As this is also a gas, indicates the upward aroma. And as the heat is absorbed, indicates a minus Q sign. Q here indicates energy. Energy means heat energy. Here is endothermic reaction.
Let us see the other side. Now, so, up to this side, what
right, third one, what we have is, evolution of gas, otherwise we can say any other point of problem. Okay, so expressing the gas evolved, next step, third one, expressing the gas evolved. So if any gases are being evolved, we can express that also. For example, better in plus hydrochloric acid again in a that is Zn Cl2 plus H2. It is a or other reaction also we can write here, even so zinc plus whatever the acid you have, okay, zinc plus H2SO4 use ratio zinc sulfate plus H2. So whatever the acid, the property of metals is whatever the metal, positive sodium, first A group, second A group elements, and also the even D block also. Okay, these metals generally, what is their characteristic property is, when we add acid, when they react with acids, they liberate hydrogen. Even in the preparation of hydrogen in the laboratory method, we use this technique only, that is this reaction, either we take zinc or something, okay, magnesium, etc. So, here we get a hydrogen. Means metals when react with acids, they liberate what? They liberate hydrogen. Okay? Right. So, both the examples, you can write any one. No problem. So, we check for the thing that we need to use chlorine. So, chlorine 2 here. So, we need 2 here. So, now chlorine 2, hydrogen 2. So, 2 hydrogen. Okay, finish. So, then you can see here the round reaction. Okay. 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, alpha, hope it is balanced. So here the liberation of hydrogen, that is the gas that is evolved. Then the final one, expressing the precipitate formed. The fourth one, expressing the precipitate formed. So already we have discussed one equation in the beginning. Okay, sodium sulfate and barium chloride. Sodium sulfate and barium chloride. So we take the solutions of sodium chloride. Sorry, sodium sulfate and barium chloride. So after the reaction, what we get? Sodium chloride and barium sulfate. Where barium sulfate is a precipitate.
Okay, we write that first here. Okay, so I am writing that one. That is okay.
So what is the example is silver nitrate and chloride. So we take AgNO3 twice. Indicating that nitrogen is a gas, nitrogen is a gas, oxygen is a gas,
The natural monoxide also is a gas, but an upward arrow indicator is formed, means the product of formed. For us, it also is a gas with the absorption of energy. So, there is the information we are getting with the help of this reaction. Then, expressing the gas valve, if any gas is around, even here also. Okay, heat changes. Here, our focus is heat changes. Okay, but the same examples we can write for gas also, always not there, because this is already gas is coming. Okay, the same two examples you can write here also. Okay, no problem, nothing mistake.
Right, expressing the gas valve. So, we get some metals like zinc. Later, you add hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. Okay, anyway, the salt that is formed is different, that's all. The salt which is formed is different, that's all. So, that is. Here we get zinc chloride if you are using hydrochloric acid. We get zinc sulfate if you are using sulfuric acid. But anyway, the liberation of gas is hydrogen only. Then next another. So especially the precipitate form. Precipitate form, as we have discussed already in one equation, I have written this one. Okay. So sodium sulfate plus barium chloride. Both are solid only. It is with an active solution actually. Even solid also is not right. So these both are active. Okay. Okay, active solution. This is only the state of care. Okay. So I have here active. And this one also active. Okay, then sodium chloride we get dissolved in that water. Okay. We get the sodium chloride dissolved. So we write active. That means it is not visible. It is not visible. Finally, we get barium sulfate. So this is visible. Okay, barium sulfate comes out, settles down under the bottom of the vessel. So this is visible. We indicate this in the downward tabular. So which indicates that it is a visible. So this is a different example for different one. And mark one more is there. So let us see around even that one also in the presence of sunlight. Okay. I told that one reaction is there, no, silver bromide in the presence of sunlight. It decomposes into silver and bromine. So where? Silver bromide in the beginning is a yellow colored compound or yellow colored salt or light yellow colored salt, which when we bring it to the sunlight, okay, it decomposes or it converts into silver and bromine, where we get the gray color. Gray color, yellow color is turned into gray color. Okay, right. So that will be so after that we will try to do some stoichiometric calculations. Okay, stoichiometric means for how many grams of the reactant, how many grams of the product we obtain. That's all. Okay. So one more reaction we got this. Exposing the other factors, so the just tell the heaviness, other factors involved. Okay, other factors involved. So here we can write as silver chloride, we have silver chloride, CaCl. Let's decompose into silver and chlorine. So this is the Skelton equation, silver and chlorine. So we did not balance here. 2AD means 2AD, very simple. So here we indicate sunlight. In the presence of sunlight. So that is one. Another one. Carbon dioxide plus water. This is your biology equation you have studied. Carbon dioxide plus H2O gives C6H12O6. So here this is a solid and this is also a solid. This is a gas. Chlorine is a gas as you will be, right? Chlorine is gas. And then here this is a gas. For your kind of information, this is a liquid and this is the starch is the solid. Yeah.
glucose, you know the name.
Glucose
is a carbon. So let us see whether it is balanced or not.
So 6 carbon, that's right. Here we have only one. So let us make it 6 and 6.
So 6 and then we give 6 here.
So 6 to 12, 12 oxygen. So here also we make it as 1, 6 to 4. Sorry, it is already 6 there. Okay, okay. So 6 are there. So we make it right here 3. 2, 6, 3. Yes. So now, 3 only. Twelve plus six, eighteen. So the reaction is balanced right now. Okay. So here, what do we get the information? Sunlight and the chlorophyll. So here it comes sunlight and also chlorophyll. Okay, students, so this is our final topic. Okay, so here in the beginning, first what we discussed is whether the name precipitate is formed or not, or first thing, heat evolved, that means whether it is exothermic, endothermic. Then we had the gas, any gases are evolved, then actually the precipitate. So here, okay, what is precipitate? Barium sulfate is the precipitate we are getting. And then this aqueous means what? Aqueous means, okay. Aqueous means that is something more water compound dissolved in water, dissolved in water. Aqueous means actually whether it is a salt or any compound, if we are dissolving little amount of compound or salt in more water, then we say that it is aqueous solution. Solution, not dilute solution, both are same. Then, other factors here are sunlight, the presence of sunlight, and this one, this is your familiar, most famous equation, your photosynthesis. What is it? Photosynthesis equation. So here, carbon dioxide and the help of water. Carbon dioxide is a gas, and water is a liquid. And then, in the presence of sunlight, because we cannot ignore this factor, suppose you know very well that. Even if you supply carbon dioxide in the water, if sunlight is absent, will this product form? Can the plants be able to produce or synthesize glucose? No, it is not possible. So, sunlight is very important. Okay, you provided carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight, but chlorophyll is not there. Is it possible? Even also not possible. So, that means both are essential. Both are necessary, both are important along with these two, otherwise you don't get the product. We get the final byproduct is oxygen. That's why we say plant as many as trees or plants to get more oxygen, because nowadays what is happening, people are cutting down trees and not planting any plants. That's why we are facing this pollution. What pollution? Air pollution. Okay, air pollution. So that what is happening, we are not getting sufficient amount of oxygen. So that's why plants are told as external lungs of living things, external lungs of animals or living organisms, mostly animals, external lungs. So we should plant. So this is our topic. So next, what will we do?
And we will go with one example.
So finally, what we are getting here, we are getting the molecular formula, we are getting the amount of moles. So all that information we are getting, yes or no? Right. So directly we will go to the example.
Example problem, what is given here?
So, friends, we will. So we do know the calculation that in the reactants, for how much of mass of the substance we take, how much of the product is obtained. So that is what we call the stoichiometric calculation. What is the stoichiometry? Okay, so let us proceed with our example given there. So what is given here is aluminium plus iron oxide. So example one, we take the first example. So where we have aluminium plus Al plus P2O3 looks like 2. Okay. Al2O3 plus Fe. So let us take it with the balance of the table. So 2 Al here. So we write 2 Al. Then this is solid. This is also solid. This is also a compound. This is also a solid. These are all solids. Okay. So now what is given here is atomic mass of Al. Okay. So atomic masses of Al equal to 27. Al equal to 27 units and iron is 56 units. Okay. P is equal to 56 units and oxygen O equal to 16 units. So this is the information already provided to us. So atomic mass of aluminium is 27, iron is 56 and oxygen is 16 units. Of one atom it is indicated here. So if we extract this into grams, what is that? It is its molar mass. Okay. So now what is given is 2 Al plus. Okay, right. I write the equation actually. So 2 Al or whatever is the skeleton equation. I keep it as the skeleton equation. I balance it here. Okay. I'll write the balance one here now. 2 Al plus 52O3 will rise to Al2O3 plus 2 Fe. So this is the balance one. Now let us see how much of this is used. 2 into aluminium from this side. So 2 into aluminium units in this. So, iron is 2. So, 2 into iron 1 is 56 plus 2 into 56 plus 3 into 56. So here again, aluminium mass again. So 2 into 27 plus 3 into 16. So finally, here it is 2 into 56 units. So here, for this many, we are writing this many. So in the reactant side, we are adding 2 into 27 units plus 2 into 56 plus 3 into 16. Aluminium two, so 2 into 27. Oxygen 3, so 3 into 16. Then 2 iron, so 2 into 56. So if you multiply, you get the value. You write that down. Okay. So this is totally 54 units. So this is 54 units, and then this is 160. So this is 160. So we are getting the R returns. So 102 plus this is the water in the 100 right. So this is what we have here. Okay. So otherwise, if you write the same thing into moles, so the same thing if you are writing, this is 2 moles, this is 2 mole, and then here this is how many? 1 mole only. This is only 1 mole. So this is totally 1 mole. So 1 mole. Okay. And then 1 mole, 2 mole. This is only 1 mole. And this is also, this is 2 moles. This is 2 moles. See here? 2 angles. So we have written 2 moles. So here this total, we did not indicate here any number. We did not indicate here any number. That means only 1 mole. So that means we are looking at this into gram. 160 gram of Fe2 only equal to 1 mole. That is the meaning. So otherwise, here 2 into layer. So this is 2 moles of. 2 moles of aluminium equal to 54 grams. 54 units if we express into gram, that becomes 2 moles of aluminium. So 1 mole means dividing by 2, you will get the number. That's it. Here what we have done? Aluminium dioxide, we did not indicate any number 1. So that's why this total, okay, this 102 units equal to 1 mole of aluminium dioxide. And again here, 2 iron. So 2 moles of iron is 112 units. 2 moles of iron is 112 unit, which indicates 2 moles of iron. 2 moles of iron. Okay. So now let us indicate steel water formation is here. So 54. Okay. This one express into grams now. So now we write the molar. So this one express into grams. So 54 gram plus 160 gram. So it is giving what? So it is giving how many? 102 gram plus here. Okay. Plus here. Okay, then it is giving 112 gram. So let us calculate this side, how much it is coming? 160 plus 54. 160 plus 54, let us calculate. So 160 plus 54. So it is 4, 6, 5, 11 and 214 gram in the LHS. And on the RHS, let us find 102 gram, 112 gram. So this is 224, this is 214. So LHS equal to RHS, we are getting same. So law of conservation of mass is obeyed here. Okay, we did not violate. So we have the law of conservation of mass also. So with the help of this one, okay, we will calculate one small calculation. We will do one small calculation. So let us see what is that. That is mass. Okay. So very, very simple calculation that is. Right. So what is asked is, suppose you are asked to calculate the amount of aluminium. How much of aluminium is required to get? Okay. So how much of aluminium required to get 1120 kg of iron. 1120 kg of iron. Okay, students. So here, when such questions we are getting, you just look at the balanced equation. We have to look at what? Balanced equation. Where is the balanced equation? This is the balanced equation. So, for what he is asking, how much of aluminium? So, aluminium is the reactant. Aluminium is the reactant. And what is the product? Iron is the product. Okay, iron is the product. So how much of aluminium required to get 1120 kg of iron? So let us just observe the equation first. So
we have this balance equation. So here we have two moles, one mole and two moles. So grams, if you see, 54 grams if we are using, how much iron we are getting? 112 grams we are getting. So with that we will proceed in the beginning. So first method we will go with that. So for 54 grams, so aluminium and iron. So for the initial, so what is given here? So for our 54 grams of aluminium, 54 grams, we are getting how much? 112 grams of iron. So that means, so for 1 gram means what we do? So for 1 gram means only 1 dollar. Right, so we need for, so how much of this is required to get what? 1120 kg. Yes or no? Okay, are you able to see this? Are you able to see this? Okay. So for getting this much of iron, how much of this one is used? So what to do? To cross multiply. So this one will be this one by, so therefore we cross multiply. So 1120 into 1000, because we are having in grams now, we convert it to grams. So into 54 divided by this 112. So this is giving us how much? What is the value here? Is we get a 1000. Okay, you can do calculation. So this is one time is 10 times. So 10 into 54. So that is 10 into 54 into 10,000. So 54. So that is equal to 54 into 10 power 5. So 3 plus 1 4. 10 power 4. 54 into 10 power 4 gram. Or otherwise, 1 kg. You know, no. So if you divide this by 1000, you will get a in kg. 540 kg. Okay, students. So instead of all this hectic calculation, simple step I will tell. So this is a simple method. Okay, here for 54 grams, we are getting 112 grams. Okay. So actually, this is 2 moles. For 2 moles, we are getting 2 moles. For 2 moles, we are getting 2 moles. See, for 54 grams, we are getting 112 grams. Okay, we need how much? Okay, we take kg. Okay, suppose if this is like this, so kg means what? We have to multiply 1000, no? So therefore, for 54 kg, you get how much? 112 kg. So how much you need here? 1120 kg you need. You need 1120 kg. So what to do here? You add 10. So 540 kg. That's all. Simple. Because here we have this one. 2 mole. 1 mole means 1 mole. Okay. For 2 mole of aluminium, we are getting 2 mole of iron. But it is given in grams. So this is the logic, that's all. But don't use this one. Better you go with this one only. Okay. So simple. 54 grams, 112 grams will be. So if it is in kg, that much only will come. So for 54 kg, 12 kg will come. So for 1120 kg means 2 multiplied by 1. That's all. So that is the ratio. If you take the ratio, this is the simplest method. Okay. But this might not work out every time. Every time it might not work out. So don't do this. So you go with this one only. Okay. Another example we will take. Okay, students, understood this? I hope you understood. So, next example, another example. Thank you.
Okay, right.
So the next example what we have is, so here it is the equation, most of the relations. So we have to think about the relations actually. So we have first thing is mass relationship. That is what we have done later on.
So for how much mass of aluminium, how much of mass of iron we are getting. So mass relationship. So then
we have volume also. So mass volume. Mass volume relationship. Relationship. And then volume also. Because gases are also involved, no? Sometimes liquids are involved, gases are involved. Okay. So volume relationship. So relationship here means what?
Among the reactants and products. Among the reactants and products.
That's all. Okay. Right. Mass volume and the number of molecules. Relationship. So these are the basic kinds of calculus.
Of course, you will get this in depth in your higher classes only, your intermediate only.
So here we have, you get a basic idea here. Okay.
You study about a basic idea.
So totally how many classes you have? So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, totally 4 kinds of relationships you will study. So we go to the next example now. Okay. So calculate the volume mass and what is given here is the number of molecules of hydrogen greater than number of molecules of hydrogen liberated when and what is our case? 230 grams of sodium reaction. 230 grams of sodium reacts with excess of water, HCl of water. And
HTP means standard temperature. Standard temperature is 273 Kelvin, which means 0 degree centigrade. Standard pressure on a constant.
Okay, and the markers are given here. So, sodium, atomic mass. NDA, sodium equal to atomic mass. So, yes, it is given to 53. Oxygen equal to 16 and then hydrogen equal to 1 unit. Okay? So, hydrogen equal to 1 unit. So,
let us write the balance of the equation first. Okay?
So, H2 plus O2 equals O2. H2 plus O2. So, here 2 into 2 4. So, here 2 into 2 4. So, here. So, 2 moles, 1 mole. Okay, volume. Right. So sodium
is involved here.
Sodium plus water. Sodium plus water gives rise to sodium hydroxide. Okay. Now here sodium is solid, so it is liquid, and we see the aqueous. And this is a
gas.
Okay.
Yes.
Then what do we have here? Two into three into four is two into 23. Unit is 2 into 18 units. And here this is 2 into Na sodium 23. Unit 23 plus 1 into 18 plus 1 into 16 plus. This many units, and here this is 2 into 1. 2 into 1. 2 into 1.
Okay, students, have you seen? So 2 into 23 sodium, 2 into 1 molecule of iron, 16 plus 2 18. Then here 2 into 23 sodium and 1 oxygen, 1 hydrogen. Here 2 hydrogen. So let us write in gram. Okay. So gram. Total is 46 units. 36 units. 46 units. So this is 36 units. So this is 46 plus 16. So this is 80. So this is 80 units. Okay. So 46 plus 36. So 40, 30, 8 and 92. So 80, 70, 82. Okay, LHS equal to RHS. So then we write this in gram. Okay. So if we write this in gram. So as for the balanced equation, what is the information we are having is, okay, we have for how much is asked here in the question. Calculate the volume and mass and the number of molecules of hydrogen liberated with 230 grams of sodium is reacting. So first, when 46 grams of nitrogen is reacting, how much is obtained? 2 grams is obtained. So that means here we write 46 gram of nitrogen. Okay, 46 gram of nitrogen. Use 2 gram of hydrogen. Okay, use 2 gram of hydrogen. Okay, so what do we have is here we need 230 gram of sodium. So 230 gram of sodium. So therefore, 230 gram of So we have got 230 into 2 by 46. Yes or no? Equal to 230 into 2 by 46. So you can cancel this. So 46. So how many times you can go? 10 gram is coming. 10 gram. And then so first calculation. So mass is over. Mass is over, and then volume under number of molecules. So let us see how the volume under number of molecules. So any gas at STP occupies 22.4 liter of this one. So STP, any gas, one more of the gas occupies. Okay, friends, I will end up here today. So, thank you for listening. The remaining 2 calculations will repeat it tomorrow. Okay, in the next class, we will continue. Okay, thanks.